Guys, as we know, some things in life just seem to make sense. Putting your head on a cold pillow at night, the smell of freshly baked bread, and that feeling when you need to sneeze and you think you can't, but then you realise you actually can. And of course, amongst those three, fluffy pancakes. Well, today we're going to be ramping up to a 10 with what might just be the fluffiest pancakes in the world. It's my attempt at a Japanese souffle pancake, which is made by whipping egg whites into a super fluffy texture and then cooked into a batter. So of course, to start, since they're pancakes, we're going to have to crack some eggs. So let's separate some yolks and whites into a bowl without breaking the yolk there, which I always seem to struggle with. No, damn it. And also spending a little bit of time removing the yolk you managed to get into the whites. So next task is to whisk together our yolks and sugar. Put some beans into it. Now let's get our milk in there. Touch of vanilla essence for flavor and just a small pinch of salt. And finally, at this stage, we'll sift our flour in with a little bit of baking powder. So now that this is incorporated well, we're gonna put our yolks to the side for the minute and do the most important step, which is to whisk our egg whites. So we'll grab our electric whisk and get started on our whisking. Damn it. And we'll hit the turbo button if we have to. Damn, look at that go. We'll just squeeze in a little bit of lemon while this is going. So we know this is done when we can flip it upside down and it doesn't fall out. And now we'll start folding in the rest of this, not really mixing it. So I think we're almost there. I'm not trying to mix this too thoroughly, I guess. So now that you definitely haven't had to fix your mix to make the egg whites the right consistency, place it onto your pan once it's up to temperature. You can see it's really nice and fluffy and it holds its shape. And now we'll just go in with some more and build up on that. And for this, we'll just put a drop of water around the edge without it splashing back at you too much. And we'll close it off and let that cook now. Oh, look at that. So I think this is just about ready to come off. Look at that. There's a super fluffy pancake. That is crazy. Let's get onto our plate. So sadly, they don't seem to hold their shape very long, but I think these look absolutely incredible. Let's finish off our garnishing. We'll just add a couple strawberries here. And of course, a little bit of whipped cream on top. So there is our attempt at the world's fluffiest pancakes. Look at that. Obviously they have deflated a little bit. Sadly, it's not quite as puffy as it originally was in the pan. They're still very fluffy pancakes. In fact, the texture is just about the fluffiest I've ever had. So with that, I don't think there's much more to say apart from cheers. Obviously there's gonna be people who make this who are far better than I am, so they can actually get it to hold the shape. But that is just so good. If you remember the cheesecake we made, it's a very similar souffle technique we used, but I think it worked slightly better there in terms of holding its shape. So I'm not sure if we did something slightly wrong or they just do collapse once you make these. You can just see all the air pockets inside the texture there. It makes it so light and fluffy. It's incredibly good. For something so simple, these actually end up being quite complicated to make because you have to get the temperatures just right. You have to get the steaming just right. But I do feel it's worth the effort since they are so, so good. Comment, what's your test next? Very cool.